This woman was found snooping around my underground vault. When she was captured, look what we found on her. The Philosopher's Legacy. This microfilm contains all the information regarding the Legacy. You might say that this film itself is the Philosopher's Legacy.
It was the smell that gave her away. No, not the perfume. It was gasoline. Motorcycle gasoline. She reeked of it.
To think that lovely Tatiana was a spy. We found this radio along with her too. Such a fine woman she was. It almost pains me to have to kill her. Yes, she was an obedient one. She was my precious little pet. Isn't that right? What was that? Do you have something to say to me?
Go to hell!
You dirty whore. I've had enough kisses from you. I should have known. Sokolov wasn't man enough to have a lover like that. Just like the KGB to send something so beautiful, yet so deadly.
What is the Philosopher's Legacy?
Very well. I'll explain it before I kill you.
During the last Great War, the most powerful men in America, China, and the Soviet Union had a secret pact. The pact was a blueprint for defeating the Axis powers and creating a new world order. To secure victory in the war, the three countries pooled their resources to conduct the most covert types of operations and research. The atomic bomb, rocket technology, the Cobra unit. And they amassed an enormous sum of money to fund these projects, enough to fight the war five times over. That wealth is the Philosopher's Legacy. After the war was won, the three countries were to divide the Philosopher's Legacy amongst themselves. This explains why the United States and the Soviet Union were able to steal away the best scientific minds in Germany as soon as the war ended. But our great motherland has far surpassed its pathetic rivals. We possess enormous wealth, the most advanced technology, and overwhelming power, assets fitting of our great country. My father was one of the men in charge of managing the Philosopher's Legacy. In the confusion that ensued after the war ended, he devised a series of ingenious plots to ensure that the Soviet Union would have total control over the legacy. The money was divided up and laundered through banks all over the world. Switzerland, Australia, and Hong Kong. This microfilm contains a record of all those transactions. After my father's death, I learned of this secret and obtained the microfilm. With this money and the support of Brezhnev and his allies, I built this fortress of Groznygrad and Granin's research facility. But that worthless fool Granin failed to produce results. I was forced to turn to Khrushchev's dog Sokolov and his invention, the Shagohod. My position in Gru made it too troublesome to attack Sokolov's facility directly. But the spy network established by the secret pact still existed. I used it to contact the boss and suggested that she defect. The boss was conniving enough to see things my way. The world was once one, but the conflict between the philosophers has torn it in two. We will use the legacy to heal that rift and make the world whole again. To do this, we need strength, an unstoppable trump card with enough power to bring order to the world. That trump card was to be the Shagohod and the Cobra unit. I have lost the Cobras, but I still have the Shagohod and the Legacy. There is nothing America can do to stop us. Boss, take this someplace safe. Take good care of it.
He wouldn't have come waltzing back in here unless he had a reason. The C3's been stolen. He must be planning some sort of sabotage. I'll go see if there are any surprises waiting for us. I'll dispose of her as well. Everything to me. Fight like a warrior, Volgan.
But of course.
Let me face him. I've been waiting for this moment. Time to get even! No more judo, and no more field strips.
Enough of this. He's mine. You will stand right there and watch. Got it?
Please, Colonel, let me...
Silence! Sorry for the delay. Let's get started, shall we? This is a once-in-a-lifetime battle. Let's make it a good one. Ah! just you and me now. And I'm gonna enjoy this.
Snake!
Volgan seems to be deflecting bullets away by wrapping a powerful electromagnetic field around his body. You won't hit him if you fire at him from the front. If you're going to attack him with a gun, do it from the side or the back.
Snake, watch out for Volgan's electric shock attacks. If you're shocked while equipping a gun, the bullets inside the magazine will ignite and the gun will explode. But he should be vulnerable just after launching a series of shock attacks. Avoid the attacks and either shoot him from his blind side or engage him directly with punches or CQC. And don't forget that the timer is still ticking on the C3 detonators. When it reaches zero, it's all over. You've got to finish him off before then.
Let's see your dodge this one!
Shoot him! Do you hear me? I said shoot him!
Sorry, Colonel. I'm afraid I can't do that.
What do you mean you can't?
I made a promise to the boss.
Silence! I am your commanding officer. Are you questioning my authority? Time to die!
You later. Right now, we've got to get to the lake and escape.
We can't leave yet. I've still got one last job to do.
The boss is already at the lake.
Huh?
She's at the lake. She's waiting for you there.
Major.
Snake, are you all right?
Yeah.
The explosion went off successfully.
Yeah, but the hangar is still standing.
The explosion was smaller than what we had hoped for because the fuel tanks didn't catch on fire.
But the fuel tanks were definitely...
Remember how the enemy spotted the C-3 while you were busy with Volgan? They must have called in the EOD to remove the fuel from the tanks then. But still, the C-3 alone should have been enough to take out the manufacturing line. That'll probably be the last one they'll ever make. You succeeded in preventing its mass production.
Snake, if you can take out the Shagahod that Volgin's in, the world will be safe from that monstrosity of a weapon. But you won't be able to take it down with the weapons you have on you. You have to come up with something else. It's time to rethink your plan of attack. First, get out of there. You need to shake your pursuers. Snake, leave the driving to Eva. You concentrate on fending off your pursuers and clearing the way for her.
Thank you.
We've only got one chance. We'll lure him over towards the other side. When the Shagohod is on the bridge, shoot the explosives. The bomb is planted on the strut of the bridge.
Thank you.
Did we beat him?
No.
As bait? Are you insane?
I'm used to this guy. I know how to handle him.
Open fire! brains in your ammo!
Who's afraid of a little thunder?
No time for this now. The escape craft is just up ahead.